Hello students, how are you all? Hope you are fine with the grace of the Almighty God. So students, as we are going through the chapter, I have prepared an animation, and with the help of the various animation, I'll help you to understand the chapter. The animation which I'm going to show you the next after this means introduction part will help you to understand the whole chapter. Then also, if you don't understand the explanation, please ask me during my live classes. You will be coming during the live classes. You ask me any question if you have. Okay. So just watch the video and try to watch full, because related to this, I will ask you questions in the live classes. So still continue. Let's begin.
Latitudes and longitudes. Just like a letter is able to reach your house through your address, a specific place on the map or on the globe can be located with the help of geographic coordinate system. The geographic coordinates of a place consist of the degrees of latitude and longitude. Latitudes or parallels are imaginary lines drawn parallel to the equator towards both the north and south directions. They are measured from 0 degree to 90 degrees in both hemispheres. The earth is round, and so the length of the latitudes decreases as we move towards the poles. Longitudes or meridians are the imaginary lines drawn between the two poles. They divide the earth in 360 equal segments, like that of an orange. The 0 degree longitude passing through Greenwich in England is called the prime meridian. One half of the world is measured in 180 degree longitudes of east, while the other half in 180 degree longitudes of west. Both the latitudes and longitudes form a grid in which they intersect each other at right angles. So, for locating a place on Earth, you need to read the degrees of latitude and longitude. For example, city of New Orleans is located at 30 degree north and 90 degree west. Remember one thing. Although a few lines of latitudes and longitudes are shown on the globes and maps, their number is infinite. So, a city can fall in any one of these crossings.
Heat zones. The Earth is a huge planet. It is spherical in shape but flattened at the poles and slightly bulging at the equator. So, the Earth has a larger circumference at the equator. Naturally, all places on the Earth do not receive the same amount of heat from the sun. While the equator and regions near it receive direct rays, sun rays become more and more slanting as we move away from the equator and towards the poles. Heat zones. The Earth can be divided into three different zones on the basis of the amount of heat received from the sun. The three different heat zones are the torrid zone, the temperate zone, the frigid zone. Let us learn a little about the position and the climate of these heat zones. 1. Torrid zone. The torrid zone, also known as tropical zone lies between the equator and the tropics, that is, between the equator and the Tropic of Cancer in the northern hemisphere, and the equator and the Tropic of Capricorn in the southern hemisphere. It extends from 0 degree to 23.5 degrees in each hemisphere. The temperature in this region is quite high. That is why it is called the torrid zone. The word torrid means intensely hot. The region experiences heavy rainfall, high humidity, and temperatures characterizing equatorial type of climate. 2. Temperate zones. The temperate zones receive slanting rays of the sun and are therefore neither very hot nor very cold. The North Temperate Zone lies between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle, and the South Temperate Zone lies between the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle. The climate in these zones is moderate or temperate. 3. Frigid zones. The frigid zones are intensely cold zones on the Earth. The word frigid means very cold. The North Frigid Zone lies between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole, while the South Frigid Zone lies between the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole. Being at the poles, the frigid zones get very little sunlight and warmth of the sun. The ground here is largely frozen most of the time and is known as permafrost, which means permanently frozen ground. Thus, the heat zones are located on the globe as torrid zone, 23.5 degree north to 0 degree to 23.5 degree south. Temperate zones, 23.5 degree north to 66.5 degree north and 23.5 degree south to 66.5 degree south. Frigid zones, 66.5 degree north to the North Pole and 66.5 degree south to South Pole.
Those places east of Greenwich will be ahead of Greenwich time, and those to the west will be behind it. The rate of difference can be calculated as follows. The Earth rotates 360 degrees in about 24 hours. Which means 15 degrees an hour or 1 degree in 4 minutes. Thus, when it is 12 noon at Greenwich, the time is 15 degree east of Greenwich, which will be 15 into 4 is equal to 60 minutes, that is 1 hour ahead of Greenwich time, which means 1 p.m. But at 15 degree west of Greenwich, the time will be behind Greenwich time by 1 hour. That is, it will be 11 a.m. Similarly, at 180 degrees, it will be midnight when it is 12 noon at Greenwich. At any place, a watch can be adjusted to read 12 o'clock when the sun is at the highest point in the sky, that is, when it is midday. The time shown by such a watch will give the local time for that place. You can see that all the places on a given meridian of longitude have the same local time.